In India, we Tibetans are not regarded as refugees. So we actually have full freedom, or you know, like almost the same rights as the Indian citizen. You know, except that we cannot vote for the Tibetan, for the Indian politicians. Like the voting right, we don't have. Other than that, for school, for you know, like any other services, for getting a job, for anything in India, it's you know, we have the opportunity like an Indian citizen. But here in India, the Tibetan people, we have to manage our own kind of living, income, and everything. So there are many Tibetan schools here in India, maybe more than 80 Tibetan schools. And most of the schools are under the Indian government, but they are for the Tibetan children. And we also have seven schools under the name Tibetan Children's Village, so TCV schools, we call them. So TCV school, we have seven branches, and in these schools, earlier it was mostly the admission was given only for those children who came from Tibet. Regarding our documents, so we have a document, it's called Registration Certificate, we call it RC. So that allows us to stay in India. And that document, we have to renew it every year. And we have another document called Identity Certificate. So we, in short form, we call it IC. That's more like a passport, but it doesn't say passport. So that allows us to travel abroad or outside India. So you also need to have a birth certificate, and we don't have that since we're not born in India. I'm not sure, you know, like whether I'm allowed to say this. You know, some of the documents, the change the parents' name so that you know you can have somebody else passport as their parents. I think, you know, living in India, personally, I think the most difficult or the problem for us is that, you know, we don't have a secure future here in India because we are not Indian citizens, and we don't have a proper, you know, like a document that allows us to, you know, permanently settle in India. So we cannot buy land, we cannot build a house, you know, you cannot own your own house. There are a lot of Tibetan settlements in India, the Tibetan government, you know, there are many institutes, and most of these land are on lease. So the Indian government has, you know, given it on lease for the Tibetan people for 50 years, and recently that lease has been renewed. So, you know, it's not our land. This NGO is started in 1997, and the main aim was to help Tibetan refugee people who were coming from Tibet during that time, in I think between 1992 to 1990, you know, like 7, 8, 9, lots of Tibetans, you know, they came from Tibet, maybe hundreds and thousands, few thousands came, you know, every year. And then during that time, for children and for monks and nuns, we had a place on an institute to go and, you know, like to look after us. Like we had the Tibetan Children's Village to look after, you know, like children who have come from Tibet. We have monasteries and nunneries to take care of the nuns and monks. For young people, especially who are, you know, above 25 or in the, you know, like late 20s, it was difficult for them because they did not belong to particular group. So, you know, like when they came, they don't speak the local, you know, like language like Hindi or English, and they have to, you know, like earn a living. So it was very difficult for them. So this NGO was set up to help them, whether in terms of, you know, teaching them languages, or, you know, like for medication or professional skills. We used to have massage classes, like yoga classes, to train people so that they can, you know, like be independent and they can start earning. Every year we try to have new programs or new events which could help the Tibetan refugee people here, or the local Indians, so anybody. So now currently, you know, like the projects that we have are our language classes. So in the language classes, we have English, French, German, Chinese, and Tibetan. And then we have computer classes. Until now, I think, you know, around 11,000 students have registered from the time we have started the language classes.